Amen.
If you can look at a man of God and fall in love with him, there are men who will also fall in love with women of God. Go back to your God and fulfill your ministry. Stop limiting the hand of God upon your life. There are women who were prophesying, who speak in tongues, who were in the prophetic according to the calendar of God, preachers of the gospel, but they are no longer doing it because of marriage. Anytime you become more emotional than being spiritual, you always take decisions based on your feelings. So immediately people speak and then you get hurt. You will love to do something you are not prepared for. You will marry a person you are not ready to stay with and you can't stay with. Get closer to God. He is the creator of marriage. He will give you ideas, make you know. The man was not created for the woman. It is the woman God created for the man. So men are the ones to value marriage, not women. But the problem is, the women have become too emotional about marriage. So the men are relaxed. A woman can do every and anything for a man she's not married to. They give their best to their fiancés. And when their heart gets broken, they retaliate against the men who will marry them. So you're going to realize that they gave their best out of ignorance. Now they claim to be wise. When they meet the right man, they give their worst. Let me tell you something. If somebody tells you that God is not needed in marriage, so everybody has gotten weaknesses. It's true. Everybody has gotten a weakness, but there are some people, they don't just have weaknesses. They are weaknesses. Let God lead you. Now listen to this. Even at the exams hall, we'll be given one question, but many answers. Choose one. Do you think all of them are correct? When you allow God to lead you, you will see like the way God sees. You will know like the way God knows. You will hear like the way God does.